fairness is not a verb because it does impact justify. No, our argument is not that the impact itself is going to be because it precludes your ability to evaluate things like substance. The first that is very clear in my fairness, but except the fairness voter that, fairness because the main competitive in trying to judge the ability to determine the better debating, insofar as that is what the ballot should decide, even if you don't think it is a good impact, the ballot should not do it come to you if you've done something that is unfair because it skews the ability to even evaluate. Second, you can see the meta constraint argument. You cannot leverage any of your arguments on the other layers because it is a meta constraint. You conceded how it was implicated. So even if you want to go for framework, take that theory, we weren't able to prove the truth or falsity of your framework in the first place. Insofar as there's some sort of fairness club that restricts my ability to evaluate substance. Now, now on your specific argument, you say that debate is intrinsically unfair, but no, even though there's slight unfairness, there's clearly other things that would clearly impact things like unfairness, which means that we should try to be as fair as possible. Even debating it can be kind of unfair, or our orientation should not be just to be as unfair as possible, rather to be as fair as possible. We should be there. You say that there are things like resource disparities, but no, we cannot, that's not verifiable in a round. You cannot justify why there's certain resource disparities in the context of this specific round have affected your ability to evaluate things like fairness as being a voter, which means that in the context of this specific round, I would justify the fairness claim that is contextual to this round would outweigh any of your arguments. Now, let's send the Michelle's property, send the interpretation. If we affirmative debaters read a standard appeal to qualify moral authorities and specific delineated text and want to see how to weigh between moral intuitions, also all the warrants I read under this theory show would clearly give reason why he can't leverage moral testimonies given because these arguments are because he does not very clearly explain what moral testimonies are in the first place, how to specify what kind of intuition about in terms of moral testimonies that proves that I was not able to answer things like that. The fact that he goes for it as reason it takes out the proves the abuse in the first place, and stretch with us back into intuition to return qualification for moral authorities is impossible to think it could just shift out in one ear as well qualification there are so that I can read alternative. An alternative testimony because you could just say that it doesn't matter because you have not provided weighing mechanisms. It's literally what you do because I read a bunch of testimonies in the next speech and you disprove all them because you say that I am not just weighing the testimony the same way you have. Also, you can see that there's an independent vote on the resolvability argument. Resolvability is not dependent on fairness either. Resolvability is an independent vote because of the clash argument that because the way without weighing specifications possible to weigh between different moral authorities which are make the weighing impossible because I can't weigh. Also, which means that we need to learn how to defend arguments which is an independent resolvability vote because we it's supposed to resolve two competing authorities and knowing how to weigh between the two resolvability. Is an independent voter because all rounds can be resolved and prevents judgment. You're not justified why resolvability should not be a voter. You've only justified why fairness education should not be voted. So you can also get 100% strength of link off of this argument now. Extend the fairness voter and then extend these like competing interpretations. Also, the reason I get 100% strength, if you don't read a counter interpretation, that means any offense on theory doesn't even matter for you because you have you can vote better risk of offense off of the interpretation. Now, you can also extend the second shell that you should have specified what type of developmental system you defend because they can change differently. Use my ability to have different strategies. So these are there are two different sort of fairness claims here that are 100% can do that. At that point, you can just vote off and strike the link. Let's see. All right, how this round breaks down. First is this question of whether you can apply moral testimony to theory. Two reasons he cannot. First is that I've proven why moral testimony can't be applicable as a framework in the first place. And second, even if we want to vote on moral testimony, I'm clearly winning this argument as to why I should be the best moral testimony in the round in the context of the role of the ballot. Now, on theory, and also the second thing is just strength of blank, right? If I'm kind of winning, if I'm at some point might be winning some sort of thing with regards to the idea of moral authority, versus he's winning literally nothing on theory. Even if you think that moral testimony might come before theory or might take out theory, if I win 100%, then I clearly still done the better debating. Which at that point you can just vote off of you can just vote off of theory.
Alright. Looks like I wrote it down. 55 the order is going to be case starting at the framework and then theory.
Move this gate. Sorry, that's not
my timer.
It's game over for Kevin. He's conceded that testimony is inescapable, which means that any starting point would be impossible without a difference to others. He doesn't actually say extend any arguments against us, which means that every single impact in the round has to be filtered through the idea of testimony being inescapable, which means that even if it's a question of fair testing, and even if he's around has been skewed, you still have to look at your different testimonies insofar as he still has no impact, he still hasn't testified why any of the fairness voters are good independent of just himself being a moral testimony. That means that you can easily vote on risk of offense on the AC since he has literally no offense there. So now let's go to the arguments about him being a moral testimony, the problem about him being a moral testimony. He says that he has a higher approval rating now, which means that he's obviously a better person right now. However, he concedes the argument that this is an indeterminate measure of how someone is in moral authority, because obviously I had a better approval rating yesterday, which means that we can't evaluate the morality of an individual based off this. Also, he concedes that he has to justify why he's a good person in the first place. He says that there's a higher risk of offense because there's no one else in the debate space is a good person, but obviously no one in the debate space isn't going to be a moral authority. That's why I write additional cards to provide a moral authority to begin with, and so far that it means he's not actually a moral authority on the issue. Even if he's just an expert, or even if he's a person of color, doesn't mean that why he's a good person in the first place. Clifton was just an argument meant to weigh between good people that were people of color, but he hasn't made an internal link for why he's a good person. But to begin with, you can accept the Kofi Annan evidence. This has gone completely conceded throughout the floor. You can vote on this at a risk of offense so far as I win the testimony framework, which is going to be really easy because he's conceded the inescapability argument. This is a vote here on 100% strength of link because he's conceded that Kofi Annan affirms. I'll go to the back of the top of the framework. He only extends that testimony into the regressive. However, he concedes all of the arguments I made against it. The first, that it's not unique because you presuppose that we can trust our own judgments and authority, but there's no conceivable non-circular argument for the reliability. Also, you can see that reductio ad absurdum argument, that's like your argument would render all testimonies unreliable, including the testimony we have to accept, like for example, a judge's ballot, which means that you can't vote for him on this issue to begin with. Also, he completely concedes that if his framework
is correct, a qualifying moral authority would have already considered it, which means that he hasn't provided a competing authority for theory, which means that we can't actually evaluate because we need an authority to evaluate this. Now go into theory.
The problem is that he concedes the infinitely regressive argument on fairness for why fairness isn't a voter, which means that it would justify reading a theory against a single loop to an argument, which means that this was 100% ring of link, which means that fairness isn't a voter. He just puts defensive response on all of your arguments. This takes away the fair testing takes out the fair testing arguments because it means that even if you concede fairness of a voter, that means that you can still look at the framework over theory because the resolvability independent voter isn't a question of fair testing, which means that I can still leverage my framework even if he wins the resolvability independent voter. However, even if you look at the resolvability independent voter, if you look at theory, it would just make this round irresolvable because if I don't have the framework of debate, then we can actually evaluate theory because all of the offense on theory would have to be framed through testimony because he can say that testimony is inescapable, which means that you have to vote the AC on a risk of offense because he's completely conceded the arguments, which means you can't look to the independent voters and you can't look to the fairness arguments. I get to leverage the AF against the theory, and insofar as he has no offense on the AC, you have to look to testimony.
Can I call for screenshots of the Uber ratings? No.